Hi, my name's Andy, and I work at Udacity. And your instructor, Joran, well, he lives in Germany, and so he couldn't be here today, but we're really lucky to have Leonard Susskind here with us today. And Leonard Susskind is a theoretical physicist at Stanford. Can you just give a little bit of information about your background?
Well, I'm a human being. I come from Earth. I came from New York City. I am a theoretical physicist by profession. I think about things like black holes and quantum field theory and elementary particles and cosmology, and I spend most of my day doing that.
And differential equations?
Every single field of physics uses differential equations. There's nothing that doesn't use differential equations. So yes, I think a lot about differential equations. I don't solve them very often. They're kind of hard to solve. And I don't do a lot of numerics with it. But the mathematical structure of differential equations is terribly important to every branch of physics, every branch.
What do you mean when you say mathematical structure?
Well, there are different kinds of differential equations, and they behave differently. There are wave equations, which describe waves moving along. There are diffusion equations. A diffusion equation describes how a drop of ink that falls into some water. Okay, how does a drop of ink diffuse throughout the water? It doesn't make waves, it just grows and becomes a blob. Those are two very, very different kinds of differential equations. There are differential equations that describe electrostatic fields, for example. And electrostatic fields don't change with time, so those are differential equations that don't have to do with time. They just tell you how things vary in space. All these various differential equations, these different kinds of differential equations, have different kinds of mathematical structure. If an experienced person looks at an equation, a differential equation, a partial differential equation, usually you can tell very quickly, is that describing waves, or is it describing diffusion, or is it describing the electrostatic behavior of something? And you can get a pretty good feel by looking at the equation, by its mathematical structure, what kind of phenomena it's describing. So, yeah, different equations have different kind of structure, and the structure is mathematical.